Over in Canada, truckers stage a massive protest against the country's vaccine mandate. More in this report.
Trucks lined roadways leading into Canada's capital, Ottawa, on Saturday as drivers staged a massive protest against Prime Minister Justin Trudeau's COVID-19 vaccine mandates. The so-called Freedom Convoy started out days ago as a rally against a vaccine requirement for cross-border truckers.
I'm not vaccinated, so I left before the 15th of January. The rule in the States wasn't in place yet, but I have other friends that say even though vaccinated now, right now, the U.S. Customs, they're not enforcing that. So they're still going there. The problem is when we come back.
But the protest evolved to a demonstration against government overreach during the pandemic. Scores of trucks from across the country, some of which made it to the city on Friday, lined up in front of Parliament, blowing their horns as thousands of people gathered peacefully on the snow-covered lawn of Parliament. The violent rhetoric used by some of the promoters on social media in the run-up to the protest has worried police, who were out in force on Saturday. The CBC reported Trudeau and his family left their downtown home due to security concerns. On Friday, Trudeau told the Canadian press he was worried about possible violence connected with the demonstrations. Earlier this week, he said the convoy represented a small fringe minority who do not represent the views of Canadians. About 90% of Canada's cross-border truckers and 77% of the population have had two COVID vaccination shots.
The UK begins vaccinating 5 to 11-year-olds amid high infection rates among school children. But as this report tells us, the shots will only be made available to the clinically vulnerable.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
Take Dad with us?
Sure.
Come on in.
Britain begins COVID-19 vaccinations this week for vulnerable children between the ages of 5 and 11. Ahead of the formal rollout, 11-year-old Xavier Aquilina became one of the first children to receive a new pediatric formulation of the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine. Aquilina, who has epilepsy, said the experience wasn't as stressful as he thought it would be.
It was more of like a kind of surprise pain, not hurting that much, but just giving you a small jump scare. Everybody here is quite nice and you get a sticker at the end.
Pfizer vaccine formulation, called Comirnaty, received approval from the British government in December. Children will only receive a third of the adult dose in two sessions over 8 weeks, in proportion to their smaller size. Joseph Todd is the director of this particular vaccine center.
Well, I think it's very important for them to be brought in and to be seen so that they can regain some sort of social interaction. They can get back to the normal activities of daily living that the rest of us take for granted.
Infections are currently high among school children in Britain, with some estimates saying more than 1 in 10 younger students are testing positive. However, the country has been slower than some others in offering the shots to 5 to 11-year-olds. Still, Britain is not planning to vaccinate the age group more broadly, unlike countries such as the United States and Israel.
Oil washing up on a beach in Thailand's east coast pose another threat to pandemic-hit businesses in the country. The Thai Navy and pollution experts are scrambling to clean up last week's oil spill, where at least 60 tons of crude leaked about 20 kilometers off the coast of Rayong Province. Pipeline operator Star Petroleum Refining Public Company said it was trying to minimize oil reaching the shoreline using booms. But an aerial surveillance showed a pollution zone of 47 square kilometers. For struggling resorts and tourism-dependent businesses in the area, the pollution and lack of swimmers could spell disaster for livelihoods.